हेलो लर्नर्स, आई एम माधुरी हुडा फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन महर्षि दयानंद यूनिवर्सिटी रोहतक. विद द बेस्ट विशेज फॉर टुडेज लर्निंग, वी आर एंटरिंग इन द 11th मॉड्यूल, दैट इज एक्सप्लोरिंग डिजिटल पेडागोजी एज द साउंड पेडागोजी ऑफ दिस कोर्स. सी, एवरीवन इज अवेयर ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ डिजिटलाइजेशन इन एजुकेशन, सच एज इट गिव्स एक्सेस टू एजुकेशन टू दोज पीपल हु लिव इन द रिमोट एरियाज ऑफ द कंट्री. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द डिजिटलाइजेशन, people are able to continue with their education irrespective of the disruption. Digital pedagogy has now become the popular concept in pedagogical sciences as the voices of future classrooms. It is believed that digital technologies are generating knowledge in new ways and new customs of education experiences. It results in technology-enriched classrooms with diverse type of digital tools and technologies which is suitable to the teaching learning context with special reference to pedagogical decisions and instructional designs. In fact, there are variety of digital tools and technologies that make education experiences wonderful and enjoyable. This is proven fact and popular saying that in framing education, pedagogy is the driver and technology is the accelerator. Pedagogy as a craft of teaching is a structure where content, instructional and evaluation strategies are organized and prioritized according to the needs, interests, and psychology of the learners. And when technology enters in pedagogy, it is transformed into digital pedagogy. This module highlights the concept of digital pedagogy and its importance. See, when technology has invaded in all the spheres of life, how can we expect the pedagogy to remain uninfluenced with it? Now it is the high time to frame and work upon digital pedagogy, which carries the essence of technology-enabled pedagogy. The learning outcomes of the present module are, first, the learners will be able to understand the concept of digital pedagogy. They will be able to understand the characteristics of digital pedagogy as sound pedagogy, and they will be able to understand what digital pedagogy is not. Special features of digital pedagogy are, first, let us see how digital pedagogy is defined. Digital pedagogy is a sound pedagogy in which teaching and learning through digital tools and technologies are rooted as pedagogical decisions. Pedagogy may be defined as the art and science of teaching. Real teachers use complete range of teaching or instruction strategies since there is no single universal approach that suits all the situations and suitable to all the learners. Different strategies are used in different combinations with different groups of students to improve their learning outcomes. Pedagogical decisions are directly related with the process of thinking and reasoning about choosing the best alternative among the available alternative resources for bringing about effective and meaningful learning for the learners. It is also concerned with much more utilization of computer technologies to boost the educational and pedagogical experiences from a critical perspective in relation to the digital learning environment. In previous modules, we have explored and discussed that pedagogy decides unit analysis, teaching strategies, learning outcomes, evaluation techniques, and teacher decisions based on theories of learning, understanding of students and their needs, interests, and backgrounds. When digital tools and digital technologies are incorporated in teaching learning context, it may result in digital pedagogy, which is a potential tool for pedagogical experiences. Here, reframing of pedagogy is required in context of digital and networking technologies. It focuses specifically on the use of technology to break down learning barriers and enhance students' learning experiences in a better way. An effective digital pedagogy is based on fundamental learning goals and strategies with integration of appropriate technology added to strengthen student outcomes and objectives. Digital pedagogy may be called reflective practice and scholarship of learning and teaching through digital technologies. It is the study and use of contemporary digital technologies in teaching learning situations. Digital pedagogy consists of digital skills, pedagogical knowledge, and understanding of content-specific curriculum appropriate to learners' need, interest, and aptitude. Digital pedagogy is the usage of digital tools, techniques, in designing learning experiences to gain better understanding of the content matter. It is also defined as digital learning experiences in digital learning environment to transform the education experiences and learning opportunities for digital age group. It also refers to the interactions between teachers, students, and the learning environment with integration of technology. Some definitions which may be useful in this regard are, first is, according to Brian Croxell in 2013, digital technology is the use of electronic elements to enhance or to change the experience of education. Jess Storm defined it as, pedagogy is not just a delivery device for the digital humanities. It should be at the core of what the digital humanities is, an academic discipline. According to Smart Classrooms 2008, digital pedagogy enhances opportunity for authentic, contextualized assessment that supports learning in a digital context. Now, why do we need digital pedagogy, and let us discuss its rationale. There is a growing need of awareness towards rational use of computer technologies in present learning context. Because in this digital age, there is enormous utilization of computers, handheld devices, and social media have been observed by the teachers and the students. Without knowing the concept of digital pedagogy, teachers will not be able to utilize these tools in designing their educational experiences effectively. Digital learning environments like online, hybrid, and face-to-face learning are based on digital pedagogy. In this digital scenario, it is mandatory for every teacher to know the suitable usage of technology in designing instructional designs to make their classroom teaching active and well-organized. They must know how to integrate digital tools and computer technologies into their lessons. Another point is the use of digital tools. A large and wide variety of digital tools are available for educational purposes. These tools make learning more enjoyable, more effective, supportive, enhancing, and enjoyable. And it is the need of the hour to make available the enriched, multifarious, and flexible learning opportunities in the form of personal learning environments to the learner. This also emphasizes the importance of digital pedagogy. Digital pedagogy also offers environment for constructive learning through which teacher constructs purposeful and significant ways for resourceful learning and work for better learning outcomes. It is also necessary to include skillfully the real-life context coupled with global context, collaborative classroom environments, and a clear alignment of curriculum, instruction strategies, and the assessment to have better learning outcomes for the students. Digital pedagogy is eligible to fulfill this purpose. According to Croxell, digital pedagogy reveals itself as a teaching technique to integrate digital tools and technologies in teaching learning context for high-quality learning experiences for 21st century learners. Digital pedagogy is not merely a way to teach, but also makes up a rapidly expanding field hosting multiple debates and schools of thought. Digital pedagogy provides clear understanding to teachers about the techniques of pedagogy with the integration of technology for digital natives in a digital learning environment. And now we will discuss what digital pedagogy is not. Sometimes it is misunderstood. Pedagogical scientists of digital pedagogy emphasize that the mere use of technological components in the classroom does not fulfill the real aim of digital pedagogy. Just using digital technology or putting videos or showing movies is not only enough for digital pedagogies to provide appropriate pedagogical experiences. Researchers have also revealed that teachers in higher education utilize digital techniques without designing and adopting pedagogical models, theories, or approaches. This is an essential requirement of pedagogical approach for designing instructional content and discussion on how instructors' interaction through machines could affect and enhance teaching learning outcomes. Teachers should know variety of models, strategies as a part of digital pedagogy. Technology should be used by the teachers in connection with their own experiences in development of their own meaningful representation of knowledge by using ICT. It is pertinent to understand the meaning of pedagogical approach, pedagogical designs, and pedagogical models. This will be further elaborated in the subsequent modules of this course. Now we will discuss about the characteristics of digital pedagogy which make it a sound pedagogy. As pedagogy is a process of escorting learner, that is caring them and bringing learning into the life. Here we discuss about certain features or characteristics which support digital pedagogy as a sound pedagogy. Researches on pedagogy have revealed that sound pedagogy has certain characteristics which are also incorporated in digital pedagogy. These characteristics are as follows. First is encouraging creativity, innovations, and motivation. The first characteristic of sound pedagogy is encouraging creativity, innovations and motivation by framing instructional design in a way to bring high learning outcomes. Creativity, innovation and motivation are the vital constituents of pedagogy. The most important feature of digital pedagogy is that the learners are attracted through various digital technologies by showing subject matter into very interesting ways in the form of multimedia, images, gaming and simulation, etc., which compensate traditional pedagogy into hybrid pedagogy. This pedagogy may be called crest of creativity, innovation, motivation and make digital pedagogy as a sound pedagogy. The second characteristic is exploration or exposition. Exploration and expositions are based on the theoretical construct of discovery or inquiry-based learning. Teachers explain the concept in a very authentic way in which given contents are explained and exposed in a variety of resources using different media. In digital environment, where every individual is digital native, it is easy to use various technologies in pedagogical designs and pedagogical practices. This feature makes digital pedagogy a sound pedagogy, which brings theory into practice. And the next is direction of activity. When pedagogical designs are planned, these features engage most vital point, which where teacher control all teaching learning activities in a sequence. Pedagogical approach based on learner-centered rather than teacher-centered or subject-centered mode. Through this, teacher may assess the learner's speed and scale and may repeat and revise, may explore variations and may adopt the principle of incremental increase in difficulty. In digital pedagogy also, teacher prepare and design activities through digital technologies to command and control the whole process and make the pedagogy easy, enriched and time-saving. Next is criticism. Sound pedagogy has distinctive feature of criticism as feedback system. It has elements of evaluation, correctness, contextual repetition and target setting. Digital pedagogy integrate high range of digital tools, techniques and devices for effective feedback. And the next is inviting imitation. Whenever models or standards are used, imitation plays an important part. Skills are best developed through the use of imitation, which is developing skills in an artificial environment. Imitation is an important moral, social, and intellectual agent. It can also be considered as a process of learning and as a method of teaching. Imitation is an advanced behavior whereby an individual observes and replicates another's behavior. Imitation is also a form of social learning that leads to the development of traditions and ultimately our culture. Digital pedagogy also involves these vital characteristics in enhancing core skills as speaking, writing, reading, listening, etc. Next is collaboration, participation, and public engagement. Due to the globalization in 21st century, this is a need of the hour that teaching learning should be collaborative and participative. Digital technologies may be good supporters of this vision. Using digital environment, digital platforms, digital tools, it is easy to collaborate and participate actively in the instructional process. This is also a vital feature of digital pedagogy. Variety of activities is supporting learning process in digital pedagogy, such as publishing, sharing, constituting knowledge, and networking. And apart from above these special features of digital pedagogy, there are some other special features which are very peculiar to digital pedagogy. These are, first is involvement of technology-enriched lessons. Technology is being used as more sophisticated and expensive way to meet learning outcomes that could not be achieved through traditional methods. Digital pedagogy is now used to develop technology-enriched lessons incorporated with a variety of technologies appropriate to the learning context. Second is, learner's autonomy is supported by technology. Learner's autonomy is a special characteristic of digital pedagogy. Through digital tools and technologies, every learner has opportunity to learn through his own speed, scale and size. Third is, bringing theory into practice. Digital pedagogy exhibits theoretical concepts into practical experiences. Digital learning experiences covers conceptual clarity of content into real-life context. And the next is, based on experiential learning. Digital pedagogy encompasses several platforms of experiential learning in their designs and application to support and focus the student on the curriculum and learning outcomes. Thoughtful integration of technology can aid experiential learning in many ways. And the next is foster creativity, innovation with digital environment. Digital tools and techniques bring creativity and innovation in educational experiences. These two fundamentals are very specific to the digital pedagogy and integral to it. And the next is opportunity to share, collaborate, and participate. Through digital pedagogy, learners enjoy opportunity to share, collaborate, and participate in the learning endeavors. Next is motivating, encouraging, and interesting for the digital natives. In this digital age, every student is digital native. This pedagogy is highly motivating, encouraging, and interesting for digital natives. Next is data documentation. This digital context is also beneficial for maintaining documentation for each and every activity employed in teaching learning activities. It is also helpful for knowledge creation, knowledge generation, and knowledge preservation for further use. And the next is maximum involvement in educational experiences. Digital pedagogy exhibits the advantages of maximum involvement in educational experiences from both the sides, that is teachers and the learners. It maximizes learning this way. And the last is cost saving, time saving and energy saving. Digital tools saves cost, energy and time of the teachers, learners and the others in designing pedagogical designs. This way it is effective from the point of conservation of resources. So now let us sum up what we have discussed in this module. There is a great concern that technology should be used as a more stylish and in an inexpensive way in education experiences and pedagogical decisions. In 21st century education, learners are digital natives. Teachers are required to develop lessons using digital tools and technologies. This need emergence of digital pedagogy. Through digital pedagogy, learners may develop their own meaningful representation of knowledge using digital tools and techniques. Digital pedagogy exhibits characteristic of sound pedagogy. Being an effective teacher, one has to train his or her mind for pedagogical innovations in the form of digital pedagogy. We think pedagogy, that is what a teacher does to infuse learning in others in context of digital tools and diverse computer technologies of present age, by avoiding the mad race of using technology illogically and without the use of pedagogical principles. I hope you have enjoyed this learning session on digital pedagogy as the sound pedagogy. Thank you.